A lot of people talk that independent game, because they don't understand the major game. If you have a real lawyer, you can get what you want from a major. If you know what you're talking about, if you go in there with, I just want to get signed. Oh, you give me a label deal and you're getting 50,000 streams a month. They're going to look at you and they're going to say, yo, you see that door? Go ahead and walk, turn around and go walk that door. You're not worth
Facts.
nothing. If you don't, it's like buying a home. You know, you buy a loan to flip a home, you got to put money into it. So put some money into your career, new artist. You know, get your streams up, real up. I'm not talking about 100,000 a month. You know what 100,000 a month comes out to? Maybe $125. You need to get 1 million. If you get 1 million streams per every platform, then you can talk that shit. But right now there's not one artist that's Latino artist that has 1 million streams per platform,
Rapper wise.
rapper wise. I'm not talking about just on. I'm talking about end of like Spotify 1 million, YouTube 1 million, Apple Music 1 million, Tidal 1 million, Pandora 1 million. That's bragging rights, Tony. You can walk into anybody. Same thing you're doing. That's why I have so much respect for you. You own this. This is you. This is you. If somebody really wants to give you that check, but I know you're not with the corporation and stuff. But if somebody got to give you that check,
Yet.
you put your value on it. You tell them what you want
Yeah.
because you built this. So
Yeah.
I knew that game just being around Pharrell and the clips. I knew that game. And so I told Omar, I said, we got to really hit these streets. We got to really put out these mixtapes. I'll tell you an interesting story about the mixtapes and how we did it. Our first mixtape, City of Gods, one of the homies, invested in it. He gave us some money. So they were like real CDs, shrink wrap and all that. You know how you do it.
The jewel
case. The jewel case,
the
thick
nice
one,
ones.
The nice ones,
Right.
all that.
Paper on the inside too, on the
yeah,
back,
all that,
everything. You know
all
what I'm talking
that,
about?
All that good stuff. We started going to these to the swap meets, right? Because I know you're Rhodium. You're talking.
This was the equivalent of the Rhodium at Santa Fe Springs.
Yeah, Santa Fe. So we went to Santa Fe Springs. I don't tell people's names or nothing like that. But we went to Santa Fe Springs. So we walk in there. We got the hottest shit. As you should feel, you have the hottest shit. You should be confident. But at the end of the day, people are gonna tell you your shit is hot or shit is whack. So we got that. So we feeling that. We go to the hip hop. At the swap meets, they got a hip hop section, straight hip hop, right? Basically, where they sell the black rappers, right? We walk in there, we give the dude a CD, yo, listen to the CD, To mind you, be honest with you, we weren't even trying to get paid for those CDs. Be honest with you, I told Omar, I was like, yo, our value is not up. What we charge, we can't charge people. Who the fuck are we? We're nobody. Let's get this buzz going. So we went to the Santa Fe Springs, we went to the hip hop side of the swap meet. The guy looked at us, he's like, that's not over here. You got to go over there for the Mexican rappers. Exactly what he said. We said, okay, cool.
They had a Chicano rap section at the
So
surface.
Then we
was,
went to the
separate,
other, we went
segregation.
To it, we went to across that, and that's where they had Chicano rap and all that. We talked to the homie over there. He looked at it too.
He heard it.
He listened to it. He's like, yo, homie, no disrespect, but this is not you guys. You guys go over there. Be honest
Swear
with
to
you.
God, I was there. We were there. We had a box.
He was carrying a box. I was talking.
Yeah, we had that
two
box.
Young kids just talking, trying to make moves. So from that,
we had no home.
We had
at
no
that
home.
Swap meet. Like so, in other words, like the rap section where, everyone was out. Who was popping at that time? Whoever was popping in 2000, 2003.
Yeah.
That should be an intro to a video, or that should be in a movie.
No, we're gonna do it. The movie coming, Tony. We smart. Documentary coming. Movie coming, everything, but
wow.
It's not finished.
Okay. Yeah, we
still got a lot.
The story's still being
ready. Story being
You're dropping gems, brother. Keep going.
Still being ready. So when they told us, I looked at Omar, I looked at us. We weren't discouraged. That's why I respect him so much. It wasn't discouraged. For somebody to be on Ruthless, which is Eazy's label, and get shelved and not really pushed, and then keep going, and then other people not fucking with you, keep going, it takes... You gotta have balls.
Resiliency. I almost gave up. I'm not gonna lie. I almost gave up a couple times.
He'll tell you the big words. I'm not gonna tell you the big words. I'm gonna talk how the haters want me to talk on this live.
Right.
He got balls. Right. So when we went to the swap meet and we don't fit nowhere. We're not good enough. Right. We looked at each other. He wasn't discouraged. And we said, like, what's the plan, Lulu? That's what he said. What's the plan? He said, give me about 24 hours. I got you. 24 hours came, let's go eat. Sat down. I said, you know what we're gonna do? we're gonna give out this shit at every fucking club, everywhere, anywhere where people say it's popping, we're going there. As a matter of fact, we're going to the Compton swap meet next. We went to the Compton swap meet. Shout out to the Chinitos over there that were running that.
What was it? Was that Plaza Mexico? No.
No, it was Compton swap meet. Straight Compton swap meet.
Oh, that's
Compton
right. That's right.
Compton swap meet. All the way to the back in the right hand. They had all this, and they had all the mixtapes. They're all West Coast shit. Because we got shitted on with our own people. Let's get it right. Our own people shit on us first.
Yeah.
When we went to the Asian guy at the swap meet, before he even said anything, I know this is not black rap and this is not Chicano rap, because that's what they told us over there. But before you say that, I got a deal for you. I'm giving you this shit for free. You can do whatever the fuck you want with it. But I just want it to be right here. He said, free? I said, free. And he's like, okay, give it to me. Give it to me. They started signing that City of Gods for $10.99 after a swap meet. We came back the following week just because I wanted to see where we're at. He's like, you never gave me your number. I was like, what you need my number for? We got rid of those in 3 days. Okay, here's a full box. He's like, you don't want me to pay you? I don't want a penny. Just make sure motherfuckers getting it and play that shit on the speakers. It's like you're playing game and everybody else. Play it. I'm giving it to you for free. So our marketing was always give it to the people. Feed them. You know, just the only reason I'm saying that is because I get so many kids that are, and I respect the hustle. I come from hustle. I ain't never had a job. Music's been my job and saved my life. Kids, if you out there and you are pressing your CDs or whatever, and it's easier for these kids nowadays because they're just telling people to go to Spotify.
Yeah.
But there's still kids out there that are hustling out the trunk and all that.
Right.
You know what I mean?
We had hard copies.
Understand. Yeah, understand.
Yeah.
So you might get further. You know what I'm saying? Maybe press out a compilation one of all the music you had and give those out. But do your research and be like, damn. Tony A said he's gonna be over here. Tony A is a respectful man. Tony A ain't gonna shit on you if you come at him in the
correct.
Right, correct. You know what I mean? So that's just the game I begin, people. So the reason I'm telling you that story is because it's always been like that for us, for BYI. I'm gonna keep it 100 with you because that's what we do. That's how I am. I know the haters are online, they're talking a lot of shit, but I'm giving you all facts. When we finally got the deal in 2006 at Interscope Records, the whole Chicano rap community was mad at us. Why them? Omar sounds like a black rapper. He's a mayatero. Look how they dress. Look how he talks. He's not Chicano rap. Why them?
Wow.
We should never do that. You should never do that, because I don't shit on nobody. But if you did, I'm a man. You know what I'm saying? I'm a man first. You disrespect me, I'm gonna disrespect you right back. Right. You know what I'm saying? But I would never stop nobody's hustle. Nobody, no other man's hustle. And that was the sad part about, if anybody asked me, yo, Interscope, the sad part is that our own people were so against us. And Interscope Records was seeing that. You know what I'm saying? Interscope was seeing like, damn, you guys are getting a lot of love. But how come there's no, you guys need more love? How come this genre, you know what I'm saying, are putting out records talking shit and this and this and this and that? And the funny thing, Tony, I know it's happened to you because you a legend. And we used to see a lot of people's favorite rappers at venues and parties and all that. First thing, they coming up, running up. Yo, much respect, homie. Yo, y'all doing it. Y'all killing it. Yeah. And it's just like, yo, we're not going to get nowhere like that. We're not going to get nowhere like that.
It'd be a lot of love.
It'd be a lot of fake love.
It'd be a lot of fake love, I guess, because we'd hear shit like, oh, like, you know, like dissing. You know how when you were talking earlier about dissing? Right. It'd be a lot of dissing. Like.
Let me ask you, Omar. Yeah. What would be some of the disses that you heard? What were they saying about you?
You know, it was never really about the music. It was more about, you know what I'm saying? Because the music is not somewhere where you can, you know, the armor's strong. You know what I'm saying? It would be more on, oh, well, you know, he's not gang banging, or, you know, he's not fucking waving a certain rag, or maybe, you know, he's not Mexican enough, or he's not rapping. Dumb shit. Shit that had nothing to do with what should matter for us to support our own.
Now
it wasn't everybody, because we did get a lot of love from we got a lot of love from a lot of Chicano artists as well. When I say Chicano, you know, I think everyone knows what we mean.
It's Raza in general.
Right, Raza in general. But there was love, but I think that in retrospect, there would be a lot more of us right now shining
Yes.
If back then there would be a lot more people supporting. Yes. And the crabs in a barrel mentality is what's keeping us from